Hello everyone, in this today video I am going to show you how to analyze a 3-inch stiffening girder of a suspension bridge. So here we can say it is 3-hinged because this A is simply supported, B is simply supported, but the internal hinge is making it a determinant structure. So it is 3-hinged. So in this question it is given a 3-inch stiffening girder of suspension bridge span 120 meters subjected to 2-point load 240 kN and 300 kN at a distance from 25 meter and 80 meter from the left support. Find the shear force bending moment for the girder at a distance of 40 meter from the left end. The central dip of the cable is 120 meter 12 meter. Find T max and draw the bending moment diagram. T max means we have to find out the maximum tensile force, which is obviously acting at the supports at this point here and here. So this total is given, this total is separated by 120. So the central dip, this is a central dip, so from here to this left side is 60 meter, from here to here it is 60 meter. Central dip is given 12 meter, and to this 240 kN is applied at a distance of 25 meter from the left hand support, and 80 meter distance 300 kN is acting. So this can be solved if we will cut the section like this, right? So it is a combination of solving a simply supported beam and a suspension wire which carrying a UDL. So this is how we are going to solve it. So first thing, I applied my summation of Fy, the first equation of equilibrium. So the reaction will be developing here in the upward direction if we draw the free body diagram. So my Va plus Vb will be this downward forces 240 and 300 kN. This is 540 kN. Then to calculate the reaction about A or B, I have to take moment about either A or either B. So I am taking moment about A. So if I am taking moment about B, means this Vb into this distance, this is 120, this 300 into 80, this 240 into this 25. So as a result, I calculated the reaction V and VB. Now I have to calculate the moment about this C, right? So moment about C from the left hand side, if I'll calculate this VA into this 60 minus this 240 into this distance, this is 60 minus 25. So this is 9000 kN per meter. Now to calculate the horizontal reaction acting at this point, because of which we will calculate the T max. So this is actually derived, this formula is derived. So H is equal to MC by H, where H is the central dip. So this H is 750 kN. But we know that H is equal to WL square by 8H, when a suspension wire is loaded with UDL. So from this we can calculate the small w. This small w is the UDL being acting upon the hangers. Right, so T max we can calculate the V is due to our WL by 2 because it is UDL. So WL by 2 square plus H square. So T max I am getting 807.77 kN. Now it is asked to calculate the shear force at 40 meter from the left hand. So shear force can be calculated beam shear minus H tan theta. This is the formula. So beam shear from the left hand side if we'll calculate, but tan theta how we'll calculate? Y equal to, we have 4 h by l square x into l minus x, and dy by dx if we'll do, that will give you our the tan theta. So in place of x I will put the 40. So this is 1.133. now beam shear in the section, this is my 290 minus 240 is giving me 50. So 50 minus this 750 into 0.133 h into y. This is my h, this is my y. So I am getting minus 50 kN. Now moment will calculate beam moment minus xy. Same thing, force into perpendicular distance minus 240 into 40 minus 25. So I am getting 8000. Now h is this one and y value I have already calculated. So moment is equal to 0. At that point, so bending moment for the girder we can draw like this, like we do for simply supported beam. This is 290, here 240 acting, 300 acting, and 250 is acting in the upper direction. So actual bending moment at 240 kN, if I will do, this is 290 into 25, it is giving 7250. At 300 kN, this is 10,000. So actual bending moment for the girder we have calculated, beam moment minus HY. So y value is 4h y l square x into l minus x. At what distance we need to calculate? At under the 240 kilonewton load, so x value is 25. So 7250 minus h into y is giving us 1317.5. Then under 300 load also we have calculated similar way. So this is our actual bending moment for the stiffening girder. Thank you for watching.